Hello, residents of Gloomhaven. My name is Adam Smith. This is Rolling Solo, and we are doing the upkeep video for the last scenario, Unreliable Medicine. There's a whole bunch of stuff we need to cover before we get into the next scenario, so I'm going to start with the achievements. So we have a sheet, or a few sheets, that are right here in front of me. And so what I did for the last scenario, which we completed and actually successfully did, was just add here that we found all the blood root for the medicine, so we add that to our achievements. The next thing that we do, or at least we'll do in this, is do the XP count. So what I've done is I've already gone ahead and I've already upped the XP based on what we should have received for the scenario. So if you win a scenario by playing on solo and you're on scenario level 1, as I've shown you in prior upkeep videos, you get a bonus of 6 XP each. Doesn't matter whether one of your characters was exhausted or not, that a character still gets the benefits of battle cards and XP as well. So we actually, with the, I guess we'll start with the Craig card. The Craig card actually got 7 XP as it shows there, plus the 6 as the bonus from the scenario. So I went ahead and I added plus 13 to what we currently had from prior, and then now we're up to 31. So 31's not bad, but as you can see up in the top there, you need 45 in order to get to level 2. So probably by the next scenario, we might, if we can get maybe 8 XP in the next scenario with the bonus of 6, that would give us 14, and that would put us at 45. So if we can go for that 8 XP and win the scenario for the Craig Hart, then we can level him up, and that will give him the ability to get another perk, which is on the opposite side of this little sheet. So the next thing we do is the Tinker, for the exact same thing, for the XP for the Tinker. So we know that he got a 6, and we get 6 for the bonus, so that ended up being a 28, so a little bit behind the Craig Hart, but at the same time, still a little far away from 45. So that's pretty much the XP count. The next thing to cover would be gold conversion. So we went ahead and actually, at the end of this one, it's kind of funny, the Tinker actually ended up getting 1 token for coins, even though we had tons littered around. We didn't actually have a chance to pick them up because we were in such a panic to try to win. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the, and just so you guys understand, these gems are not part of the game, but I'm just using them to replace the gold conversion portion. They're nice and easy to see. So this is essentially the 2. So I have essentially right here, the Tinker now should have a total of 10, being that I have two gold, so that's, there are 5 each, so 10, and then 4, so 14. And then I go take a look at their the sheet, and we've got gold notes set to 14 for the Tinker. Then the same thing for the Craig Hart, except the Craig Hart actually got a pretty decent haul. So we got 3 coins, so that turns into 6. So we can actually go ahead and, actually what we can do, since we got 6, is we'll throw away the 4 that he has here, and we'll just replace it with 2 of these, because that's a total of 10. So he's got 20 in total. So a little bit more coins for the Craig Hart, so you can kind of see there, it was 14, went up to 20, and that's essentially it for gold conversion, pretty straightforward. So then we do battle cards. So each character was able to potentially get their battle card if they completed. We picked the Craig Hart, was trying to do the Streamliner battle card. It said have 5 or more total cards in your hand and discard at the end of the scenario. Have 5 or more total cards in your discard. No, we definitely didn't do that. Most of it, because we got exhausted, and at the end of the scenario, I believe I had like 1 card left in my in my discard pile, and then nothing in my hand. He was totally exhausted. So I knew this long, long ago that we were not going to make this near the last couple turns of the scenario. So this just gets replaced and put back into the Battle Gold deck for another adventure. Come over to the Tinkerer, and the Tinkerer has a protector card. It says allow none of your character allies to become exhausted. So we didn't do a very good job of protecting our friend, and they became exhausted. That was probably the worst combination of 2 cards ever, being that they focused on the 1 character that we actually had exhausted. And honestly, I thought the Craig Hart would take most of the heat and the Tinkerer would be the one to be exhausted, but it didn't turn out like that at all. So that's kind of funny. But not at the same time. So the other thing we're going to do, which we missed in the last time we did a scenario, we didn't really focus, and now it didn't matter, because in the past one, I think it was a Quattro Scorned, we didn't win the scenario, which was scenario number 2, So I didn't go over the rewards because we never got them, but this time I want to make sure we do cover it because we did win the scenario, so we do get this as a bonus. So what's going to happen is we're going to get 10 gold each in addition to what we already have. So this is actually going to change my mind a little bit about what maybe we end up buying, but this is fairly a fairly large chunk. So 10 puts the tinker up to 24 in total. So that's a pretty big jump for him. So I'm going to go ahead and put that on as well. So the bonus of plus 10 and the bonus of plus 10. So now I'm doing some, and later on I will total these up in between. So 30 for the Craighurt will be the total, and then it'll end up being 24 for the Tinker. So now I can go ahead and take two more gold for the Craighurt. So that's pretty cool. Now we've got quite a bit of money. The other thing that's really nice is we actually get the two check marks each as a reward. So those check marks show up in, and they don't, just so there's no confusion, these check marks do not go into the perk column right away. They go into this column down here in the notes section. And only once you get three of those check marks rewarded from either battle cards or rewards here, does it convert itself into a bigger check mark that then goes into the perk column. So the Tinkerer is going to get the first two checks that he has ever had into the two boxes at the beginning. So he's pretty straightforward because he won't gain any perks from this. But the Craighurt, on the other hand, actually, that tips him over, and he now has filled one and started filling the other. So we actually go ahead and we get this perk, and we can choose whichever one we want to put it in. Now, I already did this behind the scenes just so that you guys wouldn't have to go through the pain and suffering of watching me put this into my deck, but and speed things up a little bit. So I went ahead and I really looked at the different ones, and I'm not saying that necessarily the one I'm picking here is the best one, because there's actually quite a few really good ones. Like, ignore the negative scenario effects means that, like, I'm assuming it sounds kind of generic, but it means if we had a situation in a scenario that would cause a negative effect that's kind of outside the game rules, that's just specific for that scenario, that it wouldn't affect him, the Craighurt. And that seems pretty powerful, but it really would depend on how creative Isaac got in terms of trying to toy with us. So I'm not picking that one yet, but I got a funny feeling that's going to be a real good one to pick later, because he'll likely start building things into scenarios that are going to mess with us quite a bit. There's other ones here. A lot of them involve this symbol here means you essentially, when you pull that modifier with this symbol, that it's a rolling modifier, so you pull another modifier afterwards. But it really, what they do is a rolling modifier will come up, but it also is kind of connected with a card that either increases elemental or maybe a push or pull or something like that. So there's a lot of real cool different ones you can pick from in here. So I guess the one that makes the most sense for the Craighurt, and it's not that it makes the most sense, but the one that I kind of gravitated towards the most was, I like this one. The reason I like this one is it's add one negative two card, and then you add two positive two. And I found that there wasn't enough cards that would surprise us by giving us a real big boost to our attack, and there was more so more negative ones. I also looked through the Craighurt's modifier deck itself, and if I'm correct, which I think I am, unless I missed something the first time through, I think there's only one negative, there's one negative two in the deck. So in other words, there is the times two, but let me just see here. I think in other words, it's uneven. So there is a plus two in here I found already. There is a, I'm just kind of going through them painfully. There's a minus two. So there's so we got a plus two and a minus two. And so that's essentially even. Oh, I guess it would give us an advantage then. So if I'm looking at that correct and I didn't miss it, I think there is only the one minus two, and there's a one plus two in here as well. So by putting in one more negative two and putting in two more plus twos, we actually have better odds of pulling a plus two, although, you know, it's still kind of dangerous. And none of these are perfect in terms of what they do. Like, some of these are replace one negative one with a plus one. That honestly sounds like a great one because it just gets rid of a negative instead of putting any back in. But we're doing that now by just putting in, you know, based on the ratio, we're still putting in a positive more so and adding... adding two positives in and taking it one negative. So I got ahead and taken those cards out. So you'll notice that these symbols here, you're kind of going like, what the heck are those? In the box, there's a modifier symbol down here that states which modifier deck they're from. It's just for reference. And it just means like there's essentially going to be, this is deck one of modifier. This, for instance, is deck two. And then you obviously in the box, you'd have a 3 and a 4. They all come standard, and that's so you can have a 4-player game or even play solo 4-handed. But then as you go along, each character, like the Craighart, for instance, has his box in the game, right? His actual main game box. And inside of it, there is decks of cards that are specific to him. So this modifier deck, it has this, has his symbol in it. And these cards were part of that, this deck. So I went ahead outside of this video and I pulled the 3 cards out that I wanted to add into the deck based on the perk I'm picking, just for ease of use. But I wanted to show you guys that, like, this is the kind of deck of modifications that you get. And you get these, and they add in based on the modifiers you select when you do when you upgrade perks. So that's essentially what that is. And then this, which I'm not going to go through on this video, and I know there was some asks from people to, like, people ask me whether or not I should go through the X cards. You can see here, the Heaving Swing. So I am going to go through these, though. I'm going to play one more scenario with the base cards of level 1. And then what I'm going to do is when we go to level 2, I'm going to bring out... If we can get the Craighart to level 2 would be the goal. But even if we can't, regardless, in the next Upkeep video, I am going to show you the X cards and start bringing them into play. I just want to get people familiar with the base decks first, because that's what you're going to be using the most. And then we'll bring in the X cards, because I'm not even familiar as much with using them in scenarios. But I'd like to get even more familiar with the base cards first and using the right combinations at the right time. So, long story short, those are the, what we're gonna do for the Craighart is we're gonna go ahead and check this box here, or exit off, I guess. So it says to add exactly what we're doing here. So these cards now are going to be part of the Craighart's modifier deck, which is over here. So we can now take this deck, and obviously off camera, I'm gonna shuffle this, but these 3 cards are now going to be part of his deck. So we have a little bit better odds to pull a bigger hit with him, which is good, because he's kind of one of those characters that is going to be our main fighter. So we kind of want him to be strong and have the ability to punch through some shields. So so that's what we chose for that perk. And we're 2 away from the next perk. And we're also going to get a perk when we level 2, if that happens. So anyway, that's pretty much the perk system in a nutshell. At least for the mini campaign anyway. The next thing is, and I already showed you the box and I already talked about the level X cards. So the next thing is going to be shopping. So we haven't really done much of this. In the original read-through of Gloomhaven Into the Unknown, which was the document he sent out the first time, right down here it said, it is also recommended that you only use items 1 to 14 when you start. I went ahead into the box and picked out cards that work for us, or for me I should say. And I hope you guys agree with them, but they were the Cloak of Invisibility and the Minor Stamina. And really, it was about endurance for me and being able to get out of tough situations. That was the kind of cards I wanted in my hand in case we got into situations that we could not handle being such low-level characters. But we could have easily picked other cards as well. There was other really nice ones. Those aren't the cards to pick. They're just some. So we get items 1 to 14 from scenario 1, 2, 3. Then it says every 3 scenarios played, which we've done. We now have completed our 3rd scenario. The next level of prosperity items will become available for purchase. So items 15 to 21 when scenario 3 is finished. So now items, and then of course it continues on. We get more items as we go along. So what I did prior to actually giving myself the extra bonus gold for the rewards is I thought I only had 20 and 14, but actually during the video I realized that we have an extra 10 gold. So I had gone ahead and picked 2 cards based on 20 and 14 for each of the characters. I'd picked the Iron Helmet for the Tinker and I'd picked the Leather Armor for the Craighart. Now the one thing I just noticed is that I'm not, regardless of what I chose, I can't do this one, because it's a body slot and you can only have so many body slot cards. So this Cloak of Invisibility is a body slot. So if I was to buy this, I would want to be selling this. And if I was selling this, I would be selling it at half the value that it costs. So I'd only be getting 10 back. That's not something I really want to do. So this is not going to be the most ideal card to put on the Craighart. I'm going to have to look for something different. So the cool thing is, while we're on camera here, I get to stutter and mutter and try to figure out which cards to pick. So you can see here, I've picked I've laid out the cards from 1 to 21 as per the paragraph we just read. Those are unlocked. So we have everything from 14 to 21 as kind of, or sorry, 15 to 21 as new cards. that were not available the first time I went through this, but I did this all off camera. So now we really have some options. So the tinker, the biggest weakness I found with the tinker is damage. Now, the hardest thing is, it may not be a bad idea to still go with the iron helmet. The reason I like the iron helmet was it said when attacked, let's see if I can get this to focus. When attacked, consider any x2 attack modifier card to be a 0 instead. So anytime an enemy hits me with a really big powerful attack and I'm not ready for it, in most cases what I've done is I've lost a card. Because with the low HP amount that the Tinker has, in most cases I've thought that was the wisest decision. So this is actually still kind of a useful card for him. It is a head slot card. So the bonus with the head slot card is that we wouldn't be filling up a slot we don't already have. We have like a bag slot and we have a body slot. You can go into the rules to see what the limits are on all of them, but they're pretty straightforward. If I'm correct, I think you can have 2 bag slots at max unless you have a card that adjusts or modify that, which you can buy. And then obviously body slots are body slots. So you only have 2 hands, you only have 1 body, you only have 1 head. So that kind of stuff's pretty straightforward. So I guess we gotta go ahead and pick something. Now the one thing with the Craighart is it's not really about blocking damage more so with the Craighart for me. It was more so about just having something to, I guess I went ahead with the leather armor, that was my thought originally, but now that I'm up to 30, I'm thinking it might be better to do something like this. And I noticed this card in there before. Now actually, there's a couple cards that are really cool for the Tinker for movement. And movement's actually really cool because I can add, this one allows you to add movement like for Boots of Striding, +2 to every single move action. It becomes exhausted during the turn, and then when you long rest, it comes back. We didn't do a lot of long resting in the last scenario, but we would start because most of our items are consumable items. But if we have cards that are exhausted, long resting brings them back, and that's where your strategy starts to change. So let's go through this and see. So like hide armor, not so much. The one reason I'm not really attracted to hide armor at the moment is it gives you, if I can get this to focus, you got it, okay. At the bottom left there, it says that you put in 2 -1 cards into your modifier deck. So by having the hide armor, what it's doing is it's slowing your movements and your attacks are not as efficient or effective. So this is the card that I really had my eye on and I didn't think we could afford. And this one says during your attack, gain advantage. And now what advantage is going to allow me to do, and you can, it's an exhaustible card, so it's really, really handy because it's very powerful in that you can do an attack, and now that we, especially for the Craighart who deals a lot of damage, this might be the kind of card we need to kind of change our luck in most scenarios because we've pulled really bad cards at times, and this would give us the ability to pull 2 cards from the modifier deck and take the better of those 2 results. And now that we've boosted him with x2, with a +2 and a +2, as well as that -2, we've got, you know, decent odds to start pulling some heavier cards and just it mitigates some of the luck factor. So I'm gonna go with this. I'm gonna change, instead of going with the leather armor, I'm picking this. So off camera, I'm gonna sleeve this one. We're gonna put this in his pile and all of his coins are going to disappear because in my opinion, this is a very, very worthy card to blow 30 gold on. So, and the fact it's our only refreshable card in our inventory, that's very, very cool. It goes on the head slot as well, so we're good for that. Now we come back over here to the Tinker. Now the Tinker, it would be cool to get this card still. It's 10 gold. That would only leave, that would leave the Tinker with 14. So this allows me to potentially do something where maybe I can grab like 2 cards that are worth 10 for the Tinker instead of going like super powerful, get some things that are a little more handy. The boots stuff is always seems to be around 20 for movement, so that's a little sad because I would have liked to have had a little bit of a boost. I think that'll be the next one I go after is the movement one in order to kind of boost movement. Not too concerned about attacks at the moment, but maybe potions would be useful. Like this one could be really good for the Tinker. So during your turn, heal 3 damage. So again, we get into a situation where we really need to heal up and, the Tinker is, you know, he's got the least HP. He does have the healing ability, but burns most of his cards either healing himself or the Craighart because of how many healing cards he has. Might be nice to have this where I don't have to play a card to get that heal boost. And avoids me from getting, like I did in the last scenario, I was down to almost 1 or 2 in a couple different spots there. So this would really give me that peace of mind that I might not die. So let's do this. I think this minor healing potion with the iron helmet gives me not only a way to mitigate damage against times two attacks, but also gives me ability to heal. Those are both great things. So I'm gonna choose these two from the shop. So they're gonna cost me 20. The great thing with that is I can keep four. So I have 20 to spend, but he still has four left. So the Tinker will be able to go after something and be a little bit ahead of the game in terms of coins. So I'm gonna go ahead and put these in his area for now. And then what'll end up happening is the Tinker will, I'll end up sleeving these as I normally do, and we'll have them ready to go. And the cool thing with the Iron Helmet is it's always in play. It never exhausts or consumes. So that one's really handy. And that's the reason why I'm picking it, because it's always there. I'm never gonna get hit with a super overpowerful attack. That's also gonna even help me with bless cards, like when the Shaman blesses someone and puts one of these nasty times two modifiers that's way over here into the deck, I can even block those things, right? They become zero, not necessarily block, but they just become zero. So that's pretty much it. I think that pretty much covers everything for the upkeep. I don't really have anything else to say. I know actually as I'm filming this, Isaac just released the next scenario. So I'm going to be uploading this video right now, and then I'm going to be jumping right into the next scenario. I think it's about three tiles long, it looks like. So it looks short, but based on the amount of text in it, looks kind of heavy at the same time. So anyway, I hope this one summed up a little bit more information that you guys were looking for. Again, I will after the next scenario, we will talk about X cards for both the Craighart and the Tinker. We'll do a little bit of deck management, card management. We'll swap some cards in and out that are good or not good. And maybe what I'll do is, I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. But anyway, I hope you guys are enjoying it. If you are, please subscribe. I really, really want to thank everyone for the support, all of the feedback. And I had a couple comments, people saying, are you okay with the feedback that we're providing? Are you going mad? No, I'm not going mad. Please, you know, catch me. If I do make a mistake, it's good to know this stuff. At the same time, when you guys end up playing this, you'll realize that you're going to make mistakes as well. And that's just the way it is. The games are like that. It doesn't matter how well you know the rule book. We're humans, and we are going to miss things at times, because some of this stuff is pretty deep, and it's easy to miss the odd little tiny thing. And it can actually have rippling effects throughout the game. So I appreciate all the feedback people give me, and hope you guys will continue. And I hope you guys are enjoying the journey. So until the next time, guys, keep rolling solo.